in Group B. Woods, like Nixon, can't qualify and has pride just to play for, but a win for Tabben would put him through if the Hammer nail Simon Whitlock in the other group game. Alan Tabben started the tournament with a 5-3 win over Whitlock, but was smashed last night by the in-form Andy Hamilton. The Saint is ranked number 9 in the PDC Order of Merit. Having a good year, let's hear from the Saint, shall we? He's been having a chat with Janie.
Well, a bit of mixed emotions for you so far in the Grand Slam. Won one, lost one, but you're going to need to pull everything out of the bag today.
Yes, yeah, without a doubt. My standard of play has been quite good, and sometimes, you know, the score lines don't reflect how well you've played. You know, I don't believe my 5-1 defeat to Andy was a fair reflection of my standard of play, because I'm averaging over 90-plus for the tournament. But results are all that matter, so, you know, I'd rather have an 80 average and win. So, yeah, I need to win today. I need to get some, not self-respect, but I need to show that I can still do the business, so...
So you're kind of running in third, fourth gear and you've got a couple of gears left?
I've definitely got a couple of gears left. I still haven't shown my true potential on TV, even though I've had some good games. And I'm just waiting for it to happen. So who knows, it could happen today. It may not happen today, but, you know, life's too short.
Do you think the pressure of today's game is going to up the ante for you a little bit?
Well, I'm a better player under pressure, so I hope so. I hope, you know, if my life depends on a darts match, I can win it. If it doesn't, well, I won't care too much, you know. So, yeah, it's usually my territory pressure, so fingers crossed it works for me. So, but I've too much respect for my opponent to go easy, because I know how good he is, you know.
Alan Tabben, who now will play Brian Woods in Group B. Players are ready, crowd are ready, John McDonald's ready. Here he is.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back live. We are in Wolverhampton for the partypoker.com, the Grand Slam of darts, brought to you by the PDC. And we are live on ITV. It's now time to meet our players. Would you please welcome, from Cumbria, it's Pekka Brian Woods! Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now, would you please welcome the Saint, Alan Tabben. Remember,
Alan Tabben needs a win here, but as we've just seen, you can take nothing for granted at the Grand Slam. Still in the box for us for match two tonight, Chris Mason and Stuart Pike.
Well, we saw the danger of Phil Nixon in the opening game. Had nothing to play for apart from pride and played his best darts. Here, the pressure all on Tabben, has to win. Brian Woods, again, will be hoping to showcase and show people that he's a lot better than his performances so far at the Grand Slam suggest. For Tabben, it's all or nothing. But disappointing for Woods, defeats against both Hamilton and Whitlock, beaten 5-0 by Simon Whitlock. And that was a big, big disappointment. Now, Alan Tabham, so good normally in pressure situations. All he can do is win and then hope. Tabham winning his first game against Simon Whitlock, losing 5-1 against Andy Hamilton, and that in the end could prove very, very crucial as far as leg difference is concerned. Basically, Tabham needs to win and then hope that Simon Whitlock loses against Andy Hamilton. So all to play for.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
First leg, he's got to stay focused on what Tabham needs to do in this match. Just get the win, whether it be 5-4, 5-3, 5-2. He just wants the win. Get them 2 points on the board. And leave the rest of it to Hamilton and Whitlock.
Yeah, good start from Tabham.
Classy bird, that one. All their tattoos are spelt right.
The Tash fans are in. The most famous moustache in darts, Alan Tabham.
Well, if Wood carries on in that vein, he'll find himself on the end of a bit of a thumping.
60!
Because Tabham won't let up. He's relentless. As soon as he gets his eye in, a heavy scorer, and developing into one of the best finishers on the circuit.
100.
Woods here could be a threat. In that first match when he lost 5-3 to Hamilton, it took him two or three legs to get into the game, and then they were both really slugging it out blow for blow with 100. Some really, really heavy scoring and some good finishing. So, you know, it depends what state of mind Brian Woods is in.
Yeah, Hamilton was into his stride early. Played two 52. Fantastic matches so far. Looks a genuine contender. Tabham's looked a little bit off his game. Seemed to...
41!
Seemed to be feeling the effects of the European Championships in Frankfurt, where he had a bit of a nightmare against Mr. Manley, who's sunning himself in Tenerife. As we... well, probably not now. Probably found a bar with Chrissy, and he's enjoying the darts like the rest of us.
160.
Well, needed two, of course, to leave himself tops.
100. Brian, you require 160.
Tabham from here, still favourite to win the first leg against the throw.
Alan, you require 60.
Must-win match for Alan Tabham. This would be the perfect start against the throw. Double 10.
40.
Well,
Brian, you require 88.
It's unlike Tabham. Form he's been in the last 18 months, 2 years. Just on a little bit of a...
I was going to say, it'd be interesting to see here if Woods can hit a double. Double 7. In his defeat against Whitlock, he had 18 darts at a double and missed them all.
81.
Incredible that was. 5-0. Naught out of 18 on the finishing.
Well, his tournament stats don't make good reading. Just 13%. 3 out of 23. At this level, it's not good enough. I saw you hit a double. Tabham takes an early break. Leads 1-0. Early stages. The signs.
Game on.
Not looking good for Pecker.
Well, that was a Chris Mason-like shake of the head there from Brian Woods.
No, not dramatic enough. And he wasn't on the wire of that double 7 anyway.
Well, that's given Tabham visibly a lot of confidence, that first leg, to win it against the throw. And, of course, you know, the perfect scenario for Tabham would be a 5-0 win. Leg difference all important. At the moment, Tabham minus 2. Whitlock is plus 3.
60.
So Tabham really needs a heavy win. It's a wonderful score of Pecker when he's actually finding the red bit with his first start.
Well, we saw that, didn't we, at the BDO World Championship when he reached the semi-finals, lost, ironically, since we've been talking about him, to Simon Whitlock.
100.
Yeah, he was involved in some Great matches that week. Had a wonderful run. Sure. His intention is to
60.
Have another crack at that title.
Great darts from Tabern. The switch to 19
as well. 123.
Commentator's curse. That was a poor final dart, but still favourite here to go two up against Brian Woods, who at the moment is really struggling.
99.
What, treble 18?
Alan, you require 78.
His first dart. All right, 20 for tops. And have one dart.
58.
Well, that's the second time Brian, in two legs where he snatched the last dart, pulled it badly. Missed by a mile underneath the bed.
That's a poor dart. Can't finish now. On 119, can't finish with two darts.
Sums up Brian Woods' tournament.
Yeah, just a few too many loose ones. Like I said, he'd be feeling the effects of not playing a lot of TV darts in the last 11 months.
Well, Alan Tabern, vastly experienced in the TV majors. In the last year, he's reached the quarterfinals of four of them.
Game shot in the
second. He's hoping he'll be going through to the knockout stages of this one. 2-0 to Tabern. It's looking good for the man from St Helens.
Yep, Atash takes an early 2-0 lead.
Oh,
he's got a great chance now to jump all over that. 140, that's what you're thinking. Come on, 140, 180. Punish that 41.
A lot of room.
140.
His adjustment around the 60 is very good. I mean, I've watched a lot of Tabs' darts. I've played him a lot. I think I've played him 10 times in the last sort of 18 months. And his adjustment around that 60 is very good. He can drop a dart over almost like a loop. Loops the dart in the air. Very good.
And if Brian Woods shakes his head anymore, it's going to fall off.
Has he been reading my book? I'm not sure.
140.
Book on how to play darts, maybe. Obviously, Tabern hasn't. I think it's a frustration as well. He knows what
80.
He's capable of, and it's there's nothing more frustrating in the world going up there and playing a bit like a Wally.
100.
Again, just that lurch with the last dart. Again, snatched it badly underneath the bed.
Yeah, well, Tabern will be feeling the pressure. He knows this is a match he can win and win convincingly, and he knows that's what's required
58.
To try and secure
Alan
his place.
You require 121.
In the knockout stages.
Yeah, 80 scored, so yeah. 41 left.
Stayed up. You know, that's good
89.
Thinking. We've seen a few of those in the last match. So I just don't understand that. No point going to leave yourself the ball if you're not going to go at it.
60. Alan, you require 32.
Well, six darts from here if he needs it. Surely he won't. For 3-0.
Game
lovely dart. Lovely dart from Alan Tabern.
Alan,
at the moment, Alan Tabern is keeping his side of the bargain. He has to win, remember. He's winning easily at the moment.
Well, I know how Pecker feels. It's a frustrating place up there. You just feel like sometimes you want the stage to swallow you up.
85.
Yeah, I seen that little snatch there you were on about from Tabern. Just a little jump at the end of a throw.
Perhaps trying too hard.
He's had a frustrating few days, I feel, for him.
26.
It's a lonely old place up there, and sometimes you just can't work it out. That's it, mate. Just smile and get on with it.
Well, the A to Z of head shaking on the hockey by Chris Mason. Brian Woods is up to P.
he's still an amateur. In the head shaking department, that is. Before I get any letters or notes on a postcard.
But it's all good news, this, for Tabern. 5-0 win. Rice smile as Woods hit a treble. Treble 19 it was, but Tabern back at the lipstick, and again that little lurch with the last dart.
Yeah, he does do that a lot. He's a frustrating player to stand behind, I can assure you. Not the most conventional, it's more like it from Peckert. Not the most conventional action, Tabern. But ultimately, more often than not, the release 60. Is pretty clean.
Chance here maybe for Woods in this leg.
Good last start, needs himself a finish. And we'll get a go at it. Tabern's back on 2-8.
84.
No, pull switch. Usually pretty good on the switch to 18 and 19, Alan Tabern.
Both on a shot that normally requires two trouble 20s.
140.
Should have thrown those two first.
He's going to stay there. Double 12 for Tabern. Unlucky.
Seen that pull again there. Yeah. Just pulled on the end of the throw. Right then, for his first leg.
Nought out of 18 on the doubles against Whitlock.
10 score.
Never looked likely, did it? To be honest with you, never looked likely.
And you require 12.
Looks like being 4-0.
Game
4-0 it is, and it's all going to plan so far for Alan Tabern as he bids for a place in the knockout stages of the Grand Slam of Darts. 4-0 he leads against a disappointing Brian Woods. Day three of the 2008 Grand Slam, and Alan Tabern on course.
Thank
for the win he needs to keep him in
first.
Contention for a place in the knockout stages. It's been a nightmare so far for Brian Woods. A 4-0 lead here for Alan Tabern. Needs one more, and then he's just got to hope that Andy Hamilton
62.
Beats Simon Whitlock. But still all sorts of permutations on all through the night in all of the groups. And I've got to say, I disagree with Andy Jenkins in his interview after his defeat by Phil Nixon. He was saying that, I think he basically said the group stages, you know, are not right. I think it's spot on. It's a terrific format, and every player, you know, knows the rules before
100.
They start, and every player has got a chance all the way through, you know, to the third group game. This is what makes the Grand Slam of Darts unique. So I think, Mr. Jenkins, you were wrong.
Well, I think you should have wanted to win. There was plenty to play for, incentive-wise, to keep that winning momentum going.
140!
To have the pride of topping the group. But obviously, Andy just didn't feel it mattered to him. I'm not sure how it pans out for who he would play. Taylor does manage to beat Van der Voort this evening.
Well, the bottom line is, for Andy Jenkins, whether he
57.
Finished top of the group or second in the group, he knew before he went up on stage he'd be playing either Hamilton, Tabern or Whitlock. You know, and he was 3-1 up, he was playing really, really well.
134.
And then his opponent won four consecutive legs.
Right, will he go ball? That's unlucky. Right, 17. Well, 84 now for Tabern. Wrap up. A great match.
Going to have one dart at the bull to win the match.
38.
Brian Woods, who hasn't been able to hit a double at all during this tournament, now has a chance to win a leg. Double 10.
Well,
the reaction from Woods sums up his event, sums up his Grand Slam. 5-0, he was hammered by Whitlock, and take a bow, Brian Woods. 4-1 it is, and a huge sense of relief, because I can assure you he would have gone off that stage really embarrassed after if he'd lost back-to-back matches 5-0.
Yeah, great reaction there by Peckert. Great reaction by the crowd as well. A bit of relief. He knows what he's capable of doing, and He's a character, great player.
Yeah, as we mentioned, whatever happens, he'll be back next year under the rules of the Grand Slam, the two-year cycle. By the fact he reached the semi-finals of the Lakeside World Championships, 60. Guarantees him a spot at the Grand Slam for 2 years.
Yeah, against a two-year card, effectively. So another 180 by Tavern, that's two in this match.
Well, it's a great time to hit a 180 when you're trying to win the leg to win the match.
60.
A big favourite here, Tavern, to wrap it up in this sixth leg. And then all he can do is wait and hope.
130.
Great stuff. 180 followed by 130. Left himself a possible two darter to wrap it all up.
Yeah, good performance.
56.
Got his average over
and
90.
1180.
5140s. Impressive. Double 16, Steele.
Terrific, terrific dance from Alan Tavern. And Tavern is still very much alive in the race for a place in the knockout stages in the last 16. He now has to sit back and watch as Hamilton takes on Whitlock later. Tavern wins convincingly. 5-1 to the Saint.
Tavern has given himself a very good chance of qualifying from his group, courtesy of a 5-1 win over Pekka. Brian Woods. Good stuff from the Saint. Match stats as follows. 90 plus for Tavern. Brian Woods frustrated again, hit a lot of treble ones, which must be the most sinking feeling in professional darts. 1 out of 7 on his doubles. 5 out of 12 for Tavern, 42%. Good enough. Good enough. It leaves Group B a little bit poised, with Hamilton and Whitlock due to meet later in the evening. Hamilton still tops it. Tavern now up to second with a leg average of +2. He needs any kind of a win for Hamilton or a very one-sided win for Whitlock. Either of those scenarios puts Tavern through. Let's hear from both men. They're downstairs with Janie.
Alan, you were really feeling the pressure then, weren't you? You just told me that you've never been so nervous in all your life playing a darts game.
Yeah, without a shadow of a doubt, yeah. The problem is, when you're playing a player like Brian and you know what he can do and he isn't doing it, it's harder to produce because you know he's not doing it. There's more pressure on you. So I found it very, very difficult because I know the Brian turns up, that I know of the Brian, he would beat me up. It beat me up with that performance, without a shadow of a doubt. So.
And you were surprised at your average, 90.61. You were expecting it to be in the 70s.
Well, I was. I think, to be honest with you, we both got up there and we both felt a bit of nerves and we both didn't produce anything like what we can. And I was surprised, yeah, because I kind of gritted my teeth and got a result out of it. I had to block everything out, block the standard out and just try and go for a win, you know, so... I just gutted for Brian because I know he's a lot better thrower than what he's produced this weekend.
Pekka playing for pride there. Of course, sir, any consolation that you got one leg in at the end?
Yeah, and I was looking to get that one now. I didn't deserve it, really. But it's the way it goes. If they don't go, they don't go. And I didn't perform. And well, we both didn't perform and Alan got away with it.
Mm. Our commentary team said that if you shook your head anymore, it was going to fall off.
Probably, because you do get mad with yourself because you know you can play a lot better than what I did, and it's frustrating every time you're on the wire and you stand there and you think, oh my god, and you shake your head and you shake your head, and probably would have fell off if we'd had another 5 games.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Appreciate them taking the time. Neither of them particularly chuffed with that, and understandably so, and particularly from Brian Woods' point of view. Come over, obviously, from the BDO to take part in this, desperate to make an impression, and he can play a lot better than that, I'm sure.
Yeah, I know him as well as anybody else. He's a very confident player, and he can certainly play darts. He's just had a bit of a nightmare, really, hasn't he?